I can't wait, because we are going to learn about long division in this video. Long division. And if you're like, what in the world is that? Don't worry, all mysteries will be revealed. I mean, not all mysteries, this one will. Long division. First, we'll do a quick division review to make sure we all understand how division works, and then it will be long division time. Long division is a really awesome way to divide larger numbers. We'll start with pretty simple examples and step it up from there. By the end, you'll know how to do all sorts of long division problems and will be ready to practice on your own. Now, what is division? Well, division is when you split a number up by a certain number. Let's say there are four pairs. Michael and Liam want to split the pairs, and they want to make sure it's fair. There are four pairs, and we're dividing the pairs into two groups, one for Michael and one for Liam. 4 divided by 2. What is 4 divided by 2? Yeah, 2. 4 divided by 2 equals 2. Michael and Liam both get 2 pairs. Tasty. 4 divided by 2 equals 2. This 4, the total number of pairs, is called the dividend. The dividend is the total number you are splitting up. This number 2 is the divisor. The divisor. The divisor is the number of groups you are splitting the dividend into. In this case, it's 2, because Michael and Liam are splitting the 4 pairs. And of course, this number 2 is the answer. The answer to a division problem is called the quotient. The quotient. This number 2 is the quotient. That's division. Division is when you split a number up by a certain number. Or say someone picks 9 apples and wants to split them up equally into 3 baskets. 9 divided by 3. What is 9 divided by 3? 3. 9 divided by 3 equals 3. There would be 3 apples in each basket. 9 divided by 3 equals 3. This number 9, the total number of apples, is called the dividend. The dividend is the total number you are splitting up. This number 3 is the divisor. The divisor is the number of groups you are splitting the dividend into. The divisor is 3, because the 9 apples are being split up into 3 baskets. And this 3 is the quotient. The quotient is the answer to a division problem. You know what? Let's look at just one more division review problem. There are 20 star stickers, and 5 kids want to split them up evenly so everyone has the same amount. 20 divided by 5. What is 20 divided by 5? Yes, 4. 20 divided by 5 equals 4. Each kid would get 4 star stickers. 20 divided by 5 equals 4. 20 is the dividend. It's the total amount of star stickers you're splitting up. The number 5 is the divisor. The divisor is the number of groups you are splitting the dividend into. The divisor is 5 because the 20 star stickers are being evenly split up between 5 kids. And this 4 is the quotient. The quotient is the answer to a division problem. Each kid gets 4 star stickers. All right, that was our quick division review. Now it's time to take things to the next level. We're going to learn how to divide larger numbers using long division. We'll start really simple and build up from there. It's going to be fun. First, we're going to look at 48 divided by 4. 48 divided by 4. When we do long division, we use this thing right here. It's called the long division bracket. Oh, that's a long name. The long division bracket. This is how we set up a long division problem. We put the dividend, that's the big number we're splitting up, inside the bracket right here. The dividend in this problem is 48. The divisor, which is 4 in this problem, goes right here, right in front of the bracket. It's always set up this way. The dividend goes inside the long division bracket, and the divisor is placed out in front. That's a pretty cool setup. Hey, let's set up 48 divided by 4 again. We start off with the long division bracket. We put the dividend, which is 48, inside the bracket. Then we put the divisor, which is 4, right in front of the bracket, and we're ready to go. We're going to start with the first digit inside the bracket, the 4 in 48. We are going to divide. How many times does 4 go into 4? Yeah, one time. So we write a number 1 on top of the bracket, right above this 4. Next, we're going to do something interesting. We're actually going to multiply this number 1 times the divisor. What is 1 times 4? 4, yes. We put that answer, the number 4, right here, underneath the 4 in 48. So far, so good. Then we subtract these two digits right here. What is 4 minus 4? 0, that's right. So we put a 0 here. Since we have this extra digit, the number 8, we'll bring it down. Do you see this 0 here? You don't have to worry about it. Even though it looks like 08, that's the same as 8. The 0 doesn't change the number. We're just working with the 8. Then we repeat the whole process again, except we divide this digit here, the number 8. We're going to divide again. How many times does 4 go into 8? 2. Yeah. So we put the number 2 on top of the bracket, next to the 1, and right above the 8. Next, we multiply again. This number 2 times 4. What is 2 times 4? 8. Uh-huh. We put that answer, the number 8, right here under this 8. Then we subtract. 8 minus 8 equals 0. Yeah. And there's nothing left to bring down, so we're done. And we have our answer, the quotient. The answer to this division problem is up here above the bracket. It's 12. 48 divided by 4 equals 12. That might seem like a lot of steps to remember, but there's a trick to learn them. To do long division, all we have to do is divide, multiply, subtract, bring down, divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. First, divide. 4 goes into 4 one time. Second, multiply. 1 times 4 equals 4. Third, subtract. 4 minus 4 equals 0. Fourth, bring down. Bring down the 8. Then we repeat the steps with this digit here. Divide. 4 goes into 8 two times. Multiply. 2 times 4 equals 8. Subtract. 8 minus 8 equals 0. And there's nothing else to bring down, so we're all done. The quotient, the answer to the problem, is 12. The four steps in long division are divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. Let's try another one, okay? How about 93 divided by 3? That would be fun. Let's set up 93 divided by 3. We start with the long division bracket. We put the dividend, which is 93, inside the bracket. That's the big number we're splitting up. Then we put the divisor, which is 3, right in front of the bracket. The divisor is the number of groups we're splitting the dividend into. All right, we're ready to go. Remember, the first step is to divide. We're going to start with the first digit inside the bracket, the 9 in 93. How many times does 3 go into 9? Yeah, 3 times. So we write a number 3 on top of the bracket, right above this 9. Next, multiply. We multiply this number 3 times the divisor. What is 3 times 3? 9. Yes, we put that answer, the number 9, right here, underneath the 9 in 93. Great. Next, subtract. We are going to subtract these two digits right here. What is 9 minus 9? 0. That's right. Since we have this extra digit in the dividend, it's time to bring down. will bring down the number 3. That's awesome! Okay, now it's time to go through the steps again with this digit here, this number 3. Divide! How many times does 3 go into 3? One time, yeah. So we put the number 1 right here on top of the bracket. Next, we multiply again. This number 1 times 3. What is 1 times 3? 3, We put that answer, the number 3, right here under this 3. Then we subtract. 3 minus 3 equals 0. Yeah. And there's nothing left to bring down, so we're done. Well, we have our answer. The quotient, the answer to this division problem, is up here above the bracket. It's 31. 93 divided by 3 equals 31. To do long division, all we have to do is divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. Wow, cute guinea pig. What if this guinea pig was listening and can now do long division? Nah. Maybe? All right, let's try another one. But this time, something a little different is going to happen. Let's see what happens when we try 74 divided by 6. Will it split up evenly, or will there be something left over? Let's find out. Here's the setup. We have the dividend, 74, inside the long division bracket, and the number 6, which is the divisor, is right in front of the bracket. We're ready to go. Remember, the first step is to divide. We're going to start with the first digit inside the bracket, the 7 in 74. How many times does 6 go into 7? Yeah, one time. So we write a number 1 right here on top of the bracket. Next, multiply. We multiply this number 1 times the divisor. What is 1 times 6? 6, yes. We put that answer, the number 6, right here underneath the 7 in 74. Fantastic. Next, subtract. We are going to subtract these two digits right here. What is 7 minus 6? 1. That's right. We'll put a 1 here. Now, since we have this extra digit in the dividend, it's time to bring down. We'll bring down the number 4. Awesome. Okay. Time to go through the steps again with this number down here. 14. Divide. How many times does 6 go into 14? 2 times. Yeah. So we put the number 2 right here on top of the bracket. Next, we multiply again. This number 2 times 6. What is 2 times 6? 12. We put that answer, the number 12, right here under this 14. Then we subtract. 14 minus 12 equals 2. Yeah. And there's nothing left to bring down, so we're all done with the steps. Notice, instead of a 0 down here like we've been seeing, there's a number 2. This is called a remainder. A remainder. 74 can't be evenly split up into 6 groups. There are 2 left over. 2 is the remainder. We write R2 up here because there is a remainder of 2. That's pretty nifty. And we have our answer, don't we? The quotient is 12 with a remainder of 2. 74 divided by 6 equals 12 with a remainder of 2. Amazing job. All right, we're going to look at one last long division problem. In this final example, we're going even bigger. Okay, even bigger. We're going to divide a triple digit number. Okay, let's do 126 divided by 5. 126 divided by 5. Okay, here's the setup. We have the dividend, 126, inside the long division bracket. And the number 5, which is the divisor, is right in front of the bracket. We're ready to go. Remember, the first step is to divide. We start by looking at the first digit inside the bracket, the 1 in 126. How many times does 5 go into 1? Wait, it doesn't. 5 is too big to fit into 1, even one time. So what do we do? Well, when the divisor doesn't fit into the first digit, we look at the first 2 digits together. That means we try the number 12. Huh, that's pretty cool. All right, how many times does 5 go into 12? Yes, 2 times. So we write the number 2 up here, right above the second digit in the dividend, the 2 in 126. Then we multiply. We multiply this number 2 times the divisor. What is 2 times 5? 10. Yes, we put that answer, the number 10, right here underneath the 12 in 126. Awesome. Next, subtract. What is 12 minus 10? 2. That's right. We'll put the number 2 right here. Great. Since we have this extra digit in the dividend, it's time to bring down. We'll bring down the number 6. This number down here is now 26. Very cool. All right, time to go through the steps again with this number down here, 26. So we divide. How many times does 5 go into 26? How many times does 5 go into 26? 5 times. So we put the number 5 right here on top of the bracket above the 6 in the dividend. Next, we multiply again. This number 5 times the divisor, also the number 5. What is 5 times 5? 25. Yes, we put that answer, the number 25, right here under this 26. Then we subtract. 26 minus 25 equals 1. Yeah, and there's nothing left to bring down, so we're all done with the steps. We have a remainder again, don't we? Instead of a 0 down here, there's a 1. This is called a remainder. 126 can't be evenly split into 5 groups. There's 1 left over. 1 is the remainder. We write R1 up here because there is a remainder of 1. And we have our answer. The quotient is 25 with a remainder of 1. 126 divided by 5 equals 25 with a remainder of 1. Aw, here's the guinea pig again. The 4 steps in long division are divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. When we start, we always try to divide the first digit of the dividend. But if the divisor doesn't fit, like in our last example, we look at the first 2 digits instead. And sometimes when we finish dividing, there's a number left over. That's called a remainder. We write the remainder up here next to the quotient with the letter R to show that the dividend didn't divide evenly. And that's how long division works. You did an amazing job practicing. Keep it up, and soon long division will be as easy as pie, as easy as apple pie. You know what? That looks yummy. That looks very delicious. Well done. You really got the hang of this. Thanks for watching all the way to the end and learning with me. I hope you had fun. If you want more awesome learning videos, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. I want to give a huge thank you to my patrons for making these lessons possible. You all are the best. And to everyone watching, you're so awesome. Keep up the great work. and I'll see you next video.